Hello and welcome to the non-Greg Sterlish, Greg Sterlish show, except only the substitutes. I am your host, the Pamazon. Sorry, wearing my gym clothes. Came from the gym earlier, yesterday. That's really sad. I still have my gym clothes on because I'm gross. I thought I'd be able to go back to the gym, but I ran out of time. All right, John is on. Tell your tale. Oh, Dudley.
Oh, okay. Hi. Mm-hmm. In quotation marks.
Hi.
I think you've got...
I got a little flower here. Oh, well, from my back.
So John made us giant homemade gluten-free Cheez-Its.
They're supposed to be biscuits. But I thought I didn't have enough cheese last time, so I put, like, a lot in.
They really tasted like giant Cheez-Its. They were tasty. I just couldn't eat a ton because it was like a giant slab of cheese, but it was good. Like, the Cheez-Its really do have... I do believe they have cheese in them now. Before, I was just like, yeah, this is something dyed yellow to look like it has cheese in it, but it tasted just like a Cheez-It.
Are the ones that do have cheese. Cheese nibs are the ones that are gross and don't even have cheese in them.
I've never heard of a cheese nib.
There's a reason. They're not very good. They don't even make them anymore. They're only available in Canada. Because that's one thing I will say America tends to have better of is cuisine. Canadian cuisine, every time I've had it, just seems like cheap garbage. But I don't know. I guess not everywhere in America. But, you know, when I think of Canadian food, I think of, like, Canadian rednecks, like, just grilling everything in, like, Canadian bacon fat. But I don't know. Who knows? I've never had too much of a good experience with culinary Canada, but I don't know. Maybe it's different in French Canada because French people know how to cook more generally.
I mean, everybody says there's good food in Montreal, but I went to Montreal lots of times and it wasn't very good.
Yeah, Canada doesn't exactly seem like a place of high cuisine, but hey, yo, check it out. I have out on Captain Kirk Records now. You can get this. It's the Quickville Times, Volume 1. I have an interview with Chris Chan's new biographer, Aaron Fernandez. It's a very fascinating. They are both Chris Chan's new biographer, and they are making a biographical comic series based on Chris's life. First issue.
Really?
Oh yeah.
You got to be excited about that.
Well, I'm pretty excited. I have a. There's an interview with them on. Just check it out on Captain Kirk Records. And, the Quickville Times, Volume 1. It's got some articles. It's got some new original art. The Life and Times of Christian Weston Chandler, first issue. Being out soon. Which I find fascinating.
I can see my haircut. I don't know how I think about it. Whatever. It's just hair.
It looks like your hair always does. I don't know. Your hair generally always has some, like, a relative, like, similar shape. Just very slight variations.
I have a lot of hair, as do you.
Yeah, but yours is way easier.
It's true. Mine is way easier.
Although, as you can see, people, now that I have a very short beard, I have no chin whatsoever. Like, seriously, it's like my head just goes directly into my neck. It's very amusing. But yeah.
I don't think I've ever seen you without some sort of beard.
I mean, I haven't not had one for over, like, probably 15 years. The last time I didn't, I was still in high school. I mean, I don't know. I don't know. Yeah. I mean, maybe I could. I often wanted to, just to be like Tiny Tim. But then Tiny Tim, when he had his makeover, had, like, a Monopoly Man mustache.
Oh, really?
It was very weird, yeah. He had his hair all slicked back, and he had that weird little dickie on and the mustache. Yeah, it was during his makeover era, like, circa, like, 1985. And then, oh my god, you want to see Tiny Tim's weirdest look? Look him out on Tiny Tim Chameleon. I swear to god, it's so bizarre, because Tiny Tim, for, like, this weird period in the 80s, had this other look. He looks like a vampire or something. Just look up Tiny Tim Chameleon. I swear to god, you will not believe your eyes. It's like, damn, that's Tiny Tim. But it is.
Oh, the pictures of him from when?
From, like, the 80s, when he, oh. Like, but circa 19, think 87 when Chameleon came out. Look at the cover to Chameleon. You wouldn't even believe it's the same guy. He looks so weird. Because, I don't know, he just looks like a vampire or something. It's weird. Yeah, I don't know. Tiny Tim had that weird makeover phase. When he was doing, like, Juanita Banana and stuff. Oh, that was when he was with Miss Jan. Miss Jan is such a disturbing character in the whole saga.
I can't believe that we were in... I don't know if it was a city or a town.
Oh, yeah.
Where Tiny Tim's daughter lives.
Yeah, Tiny Tim's daughter lives...
Did you know that while we were there?
Yeah, I said something, but...
You did? Oh,
I only mentioned it once because I was just like... Probably not gonna see her, and I don't want to like hound her even if I do see her. It's not like it's a huge town, but I knew she lived there because of Justin Martel. But I'm sure she doesn't want to be bothered. I don't even think she likes talking about it. I mean, especially I don't want to see Miss Vicky, would probably curse my name.
Why?
Because last time I was talking to Justin Martel, he said Miss Vicky said, "It's people like you that are ruining this. Tiny Tim should have died with his name when he died in the ground." And she was just like cursing out people.
What does that mean?
She's just kind of crazy now. Miss Vicky has really lost her marbles.
Yeah, it seems kind of like something from someone who's lost their marbles.
Yeah, she's kind of lost it. But yeah, she really gets mad if people like still like talk about Tiny Tim or like bring up anything about him.
That was his last wife?
No, he was married to Miss Sue. He left Miss Vicky because Miss Vicky kept doing, like, porno shoots, and he didn't want her to, and, like, she was like, "I'm doing it anyway."
Well, that's fair.
But then he had no money, and he worked, like, he was living in hotels. But then, you know, Miss Sue was this really, really rich woman who owned some huge, like, canning corporation or something. But she was, like, this Tiny Tim super fan from the 60s, and she just, like, found out where he lived and, like, hunted him down and was like...
Miss Vicky or Miss Sue?
Miss Sue.
Okay.
And that was after, but he was still married to Miss Jan at the time. And Miss Jan is, like...
So many.
Yeah. Well, he had never even, like... He was married to Miss Jan, but I don't even think they ever, like, really, really together very much, like, at all. They never lived together. I don't even think they ever had sex. And, like... She married him thinking he was more famous than he was, and when she found out he wasn't, she just got kind of mad and, like, ignored him. And then, yeah. But that lasted, like, you know, like, 5 years. So then he had to, after he was with Miss Jan, he was with Miss Sue, and then, of course, when he died, Miss Jan was all over his funeral, trying to get on every tabloid and saying how obsessed with him she was, and... You know, she was the one that took a bunch of pictures of his dead body, even though nobody wanted to. And I was like, all those leaked images of it was because she snuck in and did it. She's kind of a messed up person. I mean, if anything, she's probably a narcissist. Yeah, Miss Jan's kind of crazy. Yeah, and then, the whole thing was she was like, she just thought he was some huge, like, megastar still. And then when it wasn't true, she realized she just kind of ignored him. And they never lived together. But... And then there was Miss Popcorn, who was, she was there with Miss Cleo in the earliest 60s, but, that was, yeah.
Wait,
then, yeah,
Miss Cleo?
Miss Cleo was Tiny's first girlfriend.
The Miss Cleo, the psychic Miss Cleo?
No.
That's who I'm thinking about.
I wish. That'd be a great story.
Body.
But then, she got mad because... It was kind of messed up, like, because Tiny Tim was basically, like, constantly being sexually assaulted by this guy for, like, 3 years, and, like, was really, like, being, like, hurt by him a lot.
What? Wait,
yeah,
what?
It was really crazy, yeah. But he was, like, in a gang, so everybody was afraid to stop him. It was kind of messed up. But,
That's not good.
No,
that's
it was
terrible.
It's a really messed up story. But, but she kind of... left him because of it, but it's like, that's kind of messed up on its own. Like, it's not his fault.
I mean, it's Jordan. I'm sorry, I'll turn off my ringer. I didn't expect anyone to call me. It's kind of late.
Yeah, like, she left him because he was just, like, constantly being, like...
Jordan was going to be on the show, but he had a radio show instead. But he will be on the show in the future. I know he's one of our regulars.
Yeah. Yeah, but anyway, she left him because of that, but it was, like, really messed up. It's like, that's not his fault. That some dude just keeps coming over and, like, raping him pretty much, you know? It was kind of this really crazy story.
Well, I mean, that happened to me. I was walking a dog, not one of the dogs we have now, and they're trying to potty train the dog, and so I wanted to make sure I took it out when it has to go out. So it was like 3 a.m. and there was a rapist around here, and it was crazy. It was like just on, like you see on TV. He's coming up behind me fast with the hoodie over his face. I just knew that he wasn't up to any good. And
that is terrifying.
Yeah, so I could hear him getting closer, and as he got closer, I stepped aside because you don't want someone like that coming up from behind to grab you. And he pulled his hand out of his pocket, and he sprayed me in the face with pepper spray.
Oh, that's just going to make you more angry.
It sure did. I stood there for like a second. He started to come towards me, and then I ran in, and I said, I'm going to kill you now. Okay. And I was like, it was in my head, I'm going to grab you by your hair and smash you into this car fender and kill you. And he ran, so that was good.
Yeah, definitely. That's a horrifying story.
But my boyfriend dumped me. He was like, oh, I can't. I'm doing the show, Jordan. I'm sorry.
I mean, can
I send a message? Oh, I have to either
quite
answer.
Quite to that extent happened to me, but very similar. But you can. I was just
hopefully
walking.
Nothing's wrong.
I hope not.
I know.
But I was walking down the street, down Hopkins.
Jordan
and
usually doesn't call this late, so I hope nothing's wrong.
Well, you can go off. I got a crazy story to tell.
Okay.
Yeah, anyway, I had this crazy thing happen where I was walking down I was talking on Hopkins, and this car crashed into the street sign of my corner, and this huge guy gets out, and there's this woman and this guy, and when he looks at him, and he goes, "What did you see?" And all of a sudden, he like just starts beating the crap out of this guy, like completely. He's just out. He is knocked out. And then the girl is like, "That's my boyfriend. You're gonna kill him. He's bleeding out of his ears." And he's just like beating him. "What did you see? What did you see?" And he's just like, this guy is not moving. And then he turns around and he looks at me and he's like, "You saw this, didn't you?" And he starts coming after me, and I'm terrified. And then he starts following me, and I'm just hiding behind the Apollo, which is this restaurant. And it's just crazy. I'm calling 911. Nobody's answering. I call it again. Finally, they answer. Like, okay, well, you know, someone will get on it. And it's like, okay, I've been hiding for like 20 minutes up and down the street from this guy. Nobody's coming. That was horrifying. Yeah, and then, I don't know what happened to that guy he knocked out. He completely knocked the street sign off of the concrete. That dude was just laying there like, I mean, I'm assuming he wasn't dead, but he wasn't looking so good. It was pretty crazy. I don't know. I was just, the cops never showed up that I know of. I mean, it was horrifying. I don't know. The guy just completely smashed into the street sign. His front end of his car was just totally bent inward. I don't know. There's just so many weird things like that. But then there's, funny crimes I've witnessed, like that dude that was just dressed like a baby walking down the street, and he kept like wetting his diaper. I don't even know if that's a crime. It was just hilarious. He was just this giant dude wearing a diaper, and he kept wetting it and like obviously doing it. It was very weird. Look up Pamper Chew. Look up Pamper Chew. It's amazing.
Yeah, I don't think I'm going to do that.
Yeah, that's probably for the best. Pamper Chew is a very disturbed individual, but it's pretty funny because he's also a millionaire. He made all this money through, like, a Bitcoin mining, but he's just a complete degenerate, like, lunatic hoarder who wears, like, nothing but diapers. And, like, he's got custom-made diapers with this, like, weird furry character he invented on it.
So it's technically, for legal reasons, not Pikachu.
No, it's not technically Pikachu, it's Pamper Chew. It might look like a certain yellow Pokemon character, but it's not. They're not related at all. but yeah, Pamper Chew. Oh my god, he's also like a coke addict. It's just this weird, skinny, glistening dude who wears diapers all day and snorts coke and, like, has sex with furries and diapers and shit. Like, oh my god. Pamper Chew, I'm not joking. He burns diapers to keep warm. And if you look him up on YouTube, pretty much every one of his videos, he'll call it like Pamper Chew grilling or something. He grills hot dogs over burning diapers. I'm not even joking. He like will take diapers, light them on fire, put them in the grill, and he grills like burgers and hot dogs over it. He's so fucking crazy. Oh my god. And then of course he got cancer from it. Like, well, no shit, dude. You're like grilling diapers. But he recovered from the cancer miraculously. But yeah, that's Pamper Chew for you. Just this weird dude who loves. He also.
Thank you, John.
You're
I
welcome.
Didn't really need to know all of that.
Oh, I'm sorry, Dudley. I apologize. There's some real weirdos on YouTube. Hey, I know it'll be too late, but Green Schwinn is playing Sunday at Stamps. Be there or be a square or something. It's probably too late, but look up the live album that I'll be releasing.
Oh, did you call it an album?
Well, that's the correct term. It's an album. Thing.
So you have photo album albums?
I do have a nice photo album. It's gonna be a classic. But yeah, Green Schwinn. This is the first time I've played with Green Schwinn since last November. I mean, I've recorded a bunch of stuff with him, with Green Schwinn, and we've played, you know, live like on YouTube and on Facebook Live and Instagram and stuff, but. But
do
that's
you have
not
any other colored bicycles that you can talk about?
The Red Huffy, yeah. You know, we do have shows coming up, but I'm not sure the exact date. We've got, I don't know about Bad Huffy, which is when you add Greg Sturlis to the mix. The actual Greg Sturlis. But yeah, I know we've got shows coming up. You can just look it up. We have a pretty active Facebook.
Oh, you're talking about the Spurlack.
Yeah, the Spurlack. When he joins with us. It's all about the Red Huffy. But, yeah, the Green Schwinn, the Red Huffy. Of course, Captain Johnny Sausage, which is just me, is always very active. There's, Green Schwinn, new album for free. You can get it on Captain Kirk Records coming out next week. It's called Green Schwinn Party. It was recorded at this really crappy party at this dude named Cortland's house where I just remember everybody ate these really gross brownies and was just puking them up, and I didn't, and me and Andy didn't. We were the only ones that were fine. It was so gross, but yeah, I don't know. That was at this one time that Andy was dating this weird girl Brooke, and Brooke sucks. Like she's kind of lame. I don't know who's gonna tell what I'm talking about, but it was like so fucked up. She was always just like doing like the grossest, most fucked up drugs, and Andy, who is completely like as clean as you can be, was just like, no, she's not doing drugs, dude. It's like, yeah, she is. I can see her. I don't know. Andy and I don't. We did drink a lot. A lot. We drank a lot, but we didn't. We weren't really drug addicts. We weren't really druggies so much. We were terrified of even like the most basic of drugs. Although we did smoke hookah every day at that damn hookah lounge. We were always there. You know, the weirdest thing ever is spending a Christmas Day and Christmas Eve at a hookah lounge where they will go between playing Arab dance music and like weird Christmas songs, clearly trying to sound American, but they're not. So, like, you hear Rudolph the Red-Nosed Deer Man. It's so freaking weird. I love that shit. Yeah, we were there every day smoking that hookah. We used to get this one flavor every day called Queen of Sex. Queen of Sex tastes like pineapple mixed with apple and like cinnamon. It's really good, but the last time I had it, it was so gross. It's like, how did I ever use this? Yeah, anything by that Starbucks brand was so gross, man. We used to just be there all night until they closed, just kind of like lounging and just. There's nothing, I swear to God, it's like, it's tobacco, but it's some weird kind of tobacco, because you genuinely feel like, Yes, I am so relaxed, my friend. It's so weird. I love
it. It must have been enhanced by the Duddle Duds.
I think it was. I would go back there again, but I don't really smoke much, and Andy doesn't smoke at all, so he doesn't want to smoke it anymore, but it's like I would go just to try it again. I haven't had it in, like, the last time I had it was my birthday, and my 28th birthday we went there, so, like, maybe 4 years ago or something. I don't know, but, yeah, I miss that place. We just go there and, like, they either have, like, the crazy Arab dance music on, or we just sit there watching Ghost House while smoking Queen of Fortune. Yeah, and they, like, the Arab dudes would come over, what is that, boss? The Ghost House? Yes, Baliz, what are you? This is great, man. It's like, yeah, dude, check it out, the Ghost House. So we'd hang out with all these, like, high Arab dudes just throwing them Ghost House and shit. It was so fucking crazy. Oh, my God, we used to be so weird. That was so much fun. Yeah, oh, my God. Oh, I forgot to show you. I have an original ghost drawing by the dude who goes Ghost House. He sent me one. I forgot. I wish I had it with me. I would show the TV show.
Well, you could say the magic word.
What's his magic word?
Clop.
Oh, yeah. Let's, clop. Sorry, friends. I couldn't find my Ghost House drawing. I think it was too spooky and disappeared into the ghostly realms. But I'll find it for next.
Oh,
week.
Now I want to watch ghost shows. Oh shit!
But yeah, it's a really great painting. Well, I don't know if it's a painting. It's a picture of a ghost with a gigantic nose and a gigantic butt, and another ghost with an even more gigantic nose is like its lips are pressed against the other ghost's nose, and it's going, "What a blessing!" Yeah, I don't know how to describe it. But yeah, the Ghost House. Is one of the best shows on YouTube. Look it up. It is.
Oh, this is better warm.
Oh, good.
Yeah, that's good to know.
The Ghost House. It's so spooky. It's
spooky.
A spooky phantom.
Spooky.
I actually have a. He wrote a book about the Ghost House where it's a complete retelling of I forget which Jane Austen.
I guess I should say to the fans too that Jordan is okay and he will be on the show in the future. He's okay. Just got a little worried.
Oh, Wuthering Heights. It is a complete retelling of Wuthering Heights, but with ghosts from the Ghost House. It's really, really stupid. But it's like not even like done in that much of a joking way. Like it is, but it's like so serious, but the ghosts are just... And then the ghost giant Greek nose came out and sniffed it. It's it's just weird. But I also have the Ghost House Guide to Ghosts, which is another great little novelette.
You love the Ghost House.
I do love the Ghost House. Jason Steele in general, I think, is one of the best artists ever. So amusing.
Oh, so is this reminding me of the person who sniped me for $1 on a Casio I tried to win in an auction?
Oh, that's not good.
Gosh darn it.
Yeah, I do.
Was this the Casio Rap Studio?
Sadly, it was not. That I would have just... I would have just went... all out for that, but it was a cool one that I don't have, and I was like, oh, I'd like to have that one. Oh well.
Oh, and I really want to get it. It's out now. It's called Chris Chan and Andy Warhol. It's a really fascinating study on the comparisons between the two, but basically it comes to the conclusion that Andy Warhol is like a more degenerate version of Chris Chan. But I really
oh,
that.
that's interesting.
Andy Warhol does seem like kind of like a degenerate. I
don't know enough about him. I know about his art, but I personally don't know.
He just seems...
He always seemed like removed from what I could see.
Weird, aspy sort of guy. I don't know. But yeah, I want to get the Warhol and Chris Chan book. It looks really good. Huh. I love that Chris is like a legit figure now. That new series where they go to his house and they're interviewing him and he's just sitting there showing them his wall for originals. They went to his house like a month ago and he's just like sitting there. And this is Magic Chan. I am the goddess of Magic Chan, Sonichu. And it's just like, yeah, huh? But can you show us like what you do? I don't know. Whatever. No, nobody cares. I don't care. But yeah, the Casio is a sad thing to miss out on.
It is. It is. I love me my Casios. As everybody probably who, if anybody watches the show, they know. Although there's a Yamaha there, but that one did have all the blue buttons on it. So, you know, blue buttons I can hit.
What about that one down there with the orange buttons?
The one beside it?
No, on the other side of the screen.
Oh. This is the Casio SK60 sampler. Oops. It is a circuit bent one, but the circuit bending is kind of useless. I never really used to. I just turn it off. But it does a lot of fun things. Does this have batteries in it? Can't remember. Oh, it does. Can you hold my little beverage here? So here we go. All right, that's not a fun one, but it has these little sample buttons with this crazy voice percussion. And it has, this is really fun too. And the sampler is cool. You can have 4 samples on this one. Which is more than the SK1, but this one doesn't have the auto playback like the SK1 does, which I used all the time. There's also something called the Magical Singer. Let's see if I can pick a song. Do you see a song you like?
Do they have I'm Looking Over a Four-Leaf Clover?
I don't think so.
Yeah. I don't know, you know what I like.
Yeah, I know what you like. Okay. We'll do this one. Let's see here.
That sounds like music from like Super Mario World. Or something. Oh, that's not same song Peppy.
The Peppy likes what?
Now, remember we did that song with Peppy, but it's actually like the same voice.
Oh. Well, you can like. Let me stop it here. Please stop. But you can.
Yeah, we did that.
And then. There's already some. Someone's been sampling. Someone's sleeping in my bed and they're still here. And you can put effects on the samples. Pad effect. There we go. And you can reverse the samples and loop them, and you can tune them apparently, which, and you can change how they cycle. You can just have one sample, or now it's gonna go through all the samples on one key. It's a lot of fun. It's one of my favorites.
Remember when Jack Horner pulled out that plum? I always wondered why.
We're not talking about that. We're talking about Casios right now.
I know what I was thinking about it.
So this one, yeah, it doesn't have batteries in it, but this one is this one's pretty cool. These little pads are very responsive. Like, I can take the batteries out of the other one, but yeah, and it has really hilarious beats. And you can plug in a mic and it has a voice effector, but it's really like, it's not an octave or anything, so it's really hard when you try and sing through the voice effector because your voice does not come out in any in the pitch you're singing. So this is great. If you see one of these at the thrift store, and in fact you can see the price on here, I don't know which thrift store I got it from. It just says thrift store on the sticker. $9.99. That's a great deal because they go for a lot more. It also has this lovely scratch pad. Call us and talk to us about your Casios.